George Quay, good morning, sir.
Brother, good morning. How are you doing?
I am okay, and I hope you're so good.
Yeah, by God's grace, we're tired, but we're alive. I'm getting ready to go and continue with the hustle. 9 to 30, yeah. greetings to your fellow members. My man, Mr. Logic, Johnny Hughes, Mr. Roy, Alavanyo, and the rest, everybody else. I like that laughter too, Sally.
No, I'm actually going to put an embargo on it.
No, you can't put an embargo. We can pay 10 pounds. I recommend as a lawyer to guide the laughter.
I see. All right, now, George, thanks so much for joining us on AM Plus. And let me take you back a little bit. Now, I'm sure you have the hottest timeline on Facebook this morning. You've written something very, very deep for our industry. Were you referring to happenings in Kumasi for the Tigo Unplugged music show?
Yes, generally. That, among other shows that I have produced. I mean, you know, in the last 2 years, since I joined Charterhouse, first joined as a copywriter and soon to become a producer. I've been dealing with a lot of artists and a lot of events in various capacities. So, based on a few occurrences but other experiences from the past, I figured the what about time we put out something like this.
Your voice is not stable. It goes up and down. If you can work it out for us.
Oh, sorry. Can you hear me now?
Uh-huh. We like it this way.
I was saying it was dependent on a number of factors. I mean, as a show producer for the last 10 years, working on a number of events and in various capacities, and based on a few things that occurred in Kumasi over the weekend, I figured it was time we opened a very, very, very candid discussion on some of the occurrences in our industry. So, yes, it was based on what happened in Kumasi, plus a number of things that I personally experienced dealing with artists in the past.
Okay.
Not just that, but as event organizers and even media people and the fans as well.
Now, yesterday we had some reports from NYDJ concerning some of the happenings, but you were also mentioned as one of the producers. Can you tell us your side of the event? What can you also give to us as a report out of the Tigo Unplugged music concert?
Let me first apologize to my brother Ebenezer, NYDJ, for the insult that he has also received. I wish he had stayed out of it, because some of us, thanks to the events that we do, we are used to insults in Shmeketwampo. I mean, frankly, they're wasting their time insulting it because you're wearing yourself and having. Well, what happened? We were in, Sammy, pardon me, but I'm just about leaving home as well, so you might hear a lot of noise.
Opening okay. Gate in there, okay.
I'm a bit late to work, but good. We were contracted to produce an event for one of the clients, and that's the Tigo Music on Plot concert. We had the first one in Accra at the Ohenajan Sports Stadium last year. This year, the clients decided to take it out of Accra, and I think in one of their interviews, I heard that eventually it might be a show that will be on the road. So next year, it might hit another town or another city. So, of course, we took our expertise to the table, and we did the best that we could to make the show a success. Now, we did not directly engage the artists. Most of them were engaged from the client's point of view. My mandate was, for setup and execution of the show, which I think we did to the best of our ability. However, I mean, when you're producing a show, one of the things that you need to take into focus is the fans. When you're taking the funds into consideration, what I'm talking about is that when they are spending, you need to make sure that the show is alive, it is rocking, and it doesn't drag. One of the ways you can achieve that is to make sure that, especially when you have a lot of artists on the bill, as we did on this show, you make sure that the event starts on time. By God's grace, Kumasi blessed us with a clear weather, and the show was more or less a free show, so the audience showed up. Yes, some of them did not show up too early, but eventually they showed up. And you would have hoped that for an event like this, at least our plans, our projections was that by 8:30 or latest 9 o'clock we would have started. If we had started at that time, we were looking at ending the show around 2:30 a.m. However, as at 11, we were now having our first artist on stage. We had had a couple of other artists on stage warming up, underground acts. When you go anywhere, and Kumasi is blessed with a lot of talent, so they were given the opportunity. Some of them, the underground acts, were given the opportunity to create the stage. One act, who I won't call an underground act, but she's coming up very strongly, and she rocked, she did very well for me, was Ohima Dada, I think that's her name, and I salute her for her splendid performance. But eventually the show took off, and most of the artists put up good acts generally. I mean, if the ones that I thought did exceptionally well, Shatawale, Prior, well, that's Big J and Prior TTS, the BVIP, I thought was splendid. And, well, a couple of others. EL also did great, but I thought he didn't need to do a lot of some of the songs that he did, because he had very, very big tracks that I expected him to do on the stage. But he also did well. Generally, most of the artists did well. Now, because the event had started late, every artist that came in, I spoke to them as an event producer. My mandate was to produce the event, make sure everybody left the venue with something to be happy about. So I spoke to them that, okay, we started very late. We don't need to leave here tomorrow morning. Some people have plans of probably even passing by the nightclub or other places before they get home. Let's all give them a good show. I did not engage the artists initially. I did not sign their contract with them. My mandate was not that. It was to make sure that whatever they put up on stage was good. It went well. So I took it upon myself in discussion with the rest of the team members that, okay, let us persuade, or rather appeal to the artists, because really, you need to respect them. They put in a lot of work before they come on stage. If an artist has been given, say, even 10 minutes to perform, definitely you put in a lot of hard work to make sure that that 10 minutes is exceptional. So if just before he goes on stage, you tell him that, Charlie, I need to cut down your act, your performance, but sometimes it baffles a little bit. But for me, it is not the first time that has happened. We've done it several times. There was even one Vodafone Ghana Music Awards event that we did, that there were even artists that flew in from Niger that didn't even mount the stage because we did not have the time. The show was dragging, and we needed to move on. Some that flew all the way down had been paid. We negotiated with them, pleaded with them. You can't command them. It's not possible to command them. You can only persuade and, you know, reason with them to, you know, do something about their time. And a lot of the artists, shout out to artists like EL, they managed to understand that. Shout out to artists like Liz V. Shout out to artists like Shatawale. Shatawale was great on the night. He cut off his act, bang, 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 give the people a good show. No break to now talk to the artists. No break to now stop and do this. No break, no. They just went on straight, did the act, and it was beautiful. They were very happy. And we thank those that were able to understand that. Perhaps it comes with maturity. So they know how it is. They know how events are sometimes go. But floating stone, about 20 minutes before you went on stage, I came to you backstage personally. I greeted them all in the room. I was very happy to see his son there as well. I greeted all of them. We even exchanged hugs and all that. Then I went on my one knee because he was sitting seated in a chair. And I appealed to him and said, bro, Charlie, I need you to... how long are you doing? He said, 25 minutes. And I said, can you cut it down to 10? He said, oh, 10, they're killing a wedding. And I said, how about 15? We spoke. And I think eventually we agreed at something around 12. I stand to be corrected. I know it was supposed to be about 12 or 15. And his DJ, I think Slim DJ or so, that's what he's called. And I hear he's a very good DJ. So I figured, well, thank God you have a very good DJ. So regardless what you've prepared, your very good DJ, who you've worked with for so long, will be able to do something about it. That's professionalism. And I've seen Sakodia and DJ Manson do it a number of times, and they are very good at it. So I trusted it was going to go so. Now, our brother comes on stage. Naturally, it's his home, commands a lot of fans and all that. Perform and go. You perform a bit, stand, talk to the crowd, stop small, do some a cappella, you go. It was all okay. But Talisman, time was running out for me. I had a long list of artists to go through. You understand? So I started telling his DJ. And by the time they had done about 17 minutes, that was when I started talking to the DJ that, dude, Tali, we agreed we're going to cut this thing. And we had all agreed that we're going to cut it. So what is going on now? So yes, naturally, I started giving the DJ, and not just me, almost everybody that was there. We started giving the pressure. That's how we need to do this. Tommy, I think I heard Logan Stone say cut his console. Ask Frank questions. Whether anybody touched his console. Whether anybody muted a mic. Whether anybody did anything. He did anything. There were times that DKB went on stage. I don't know if that was when he thought DKB was coming to cut him, but DKB had gone on stage several times. So even down with the artist on the stage. Yes, I had told DKB at some point that, look, if a guy is taking too long, please go there and cut him. We waited, his brother came on stage, they performed, was still going on and on. They had gone past the 20 minutes. The video is there. You can come and look at it. Nobody cut him. So when he, I think I saw the DJ stopped playing and the DJ was going, then he made that comment. He called DJ, DJ back and told him that go ahead, finish your act. Because it was very uncalled for, very heartbreaking, and very unfortunate. You cannot go on stage and say that, and it was very unfortunate. So I mean, let me say here that no artist was happy about having their time cut. No artist. All the artists were not happy. Right? Everybody, nobody was happy about having their time cut. But they were matured about it. They came to me backstage and they spoke. Look, one artist who was very, very unhappy about it was EL. But he didn't misbehave on the stage. Sorry if misbehave is a harsh word, but that's how I saw it. EL did not do anything like that on stage. He respected the fans. He respected the brand that had called him. Don't even respect the organizers, but respect the brand that had paid you. And then you did that on the stage. EL, when he finished, it was his management that came to me back there and said, Charlie, guys, this is not cool. We weren't happy about it. And you know, we'll find an amicable way to solve it because we will work together again. But tell me, Sammy, if you're the head of marketing for Tigo and your brand has been put in the public dismay, has been publicly branded or brandished or more or less punished like that, would you be able to invite such an artist on your platform again? I thought it was unfortunate. And you see, I also admit that perhaps for the organizers to put so many artists on one night, it was a bit unfortunate. Or for them to initially in their contract give so many artists so many performance times, it was a bit unfortunate. So maybe it's also about time, maybe organizations like that let agencies handle some of these things for them. But then again, I also agree that, yeah, sometimes you like to do a few things in-house. They have very good relationships with their artists, so I'm sure they were sure they could leverage on some of these relationships to be able to carry some of these events through. And I'm sure it was some of that relationship that also made them promise, oh, we'll pick you up and all that. Funny, if you were in Kumasi last Saturday, due to the crowd turn-up, I think it was even bigger than the turnout in Accra. There was a lot of traffic around the stadium. So any driver that would leave there, it might take the driver some time to get to the venue. I didn't even know that drivers were going to pick them. My mandate was, George Quay, you're at the stadium, produce this event with the best of your ability. That is what I do, and that was what I did. Those that knew and understood the elements of event production reasoned with me, were able to trim the time. Even still, we ended up at 5 a.m. because the artists were hot. But unfortunately, well, it happened, and it's past and gone. I mean, for those that felt slighted or offended by my post, I'm sorry, but the truth is the truth. It can only be one. And I said it as it should be said. Tomorrow evening, we'll do further